In the wilderness, where the water is, we're crying out, Lord, for you to hear. Fill our cups, Lord, until we overflow. We need you right now.
For the Lord is good. I want to say that one more time. Hallelujah. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. Now, I know that you believe that. Hallelujah. That the Lord is good. Hallelujah. Every time we turn around, hallelujah, God is being good. Hallelujah. For he is a good God. Thank you, Jesus. And his truth endureth to all generations. Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Let us pray. All wise and eternal God, we come before you this morning with grateful and humble hearts. We praise you today not only because this is what you have commanded us to do, but we praise you because you are God. You are Jehovah Shammah, the God of our peace. Hallelujah. You are El Shaddai. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. We want to thank you for your goodness. We acknowledge that you are the true and living God, and that there is no other before you, oh God. And we thank you, God, that we are your people. We confess our sins before you and ask for your forgiveness. And we thank you for the blood of Jesus that washes away all those sins. Father God, we thank you for last night's rest. And we thank you, oh God, for our early rising. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. We are so blessed to be able to lift up your voice just one more time. God, in the name of Jesus, in your sanctuary, God, we give you praise and we give you honor, Father God. Father, as we move further and higher in the service, God, I ask in the name of Jesus, God, that your Holy Spirit will come and rest. Hallelujah, oh God. I ask that a fresh anointing will be upon the musicians and the psalmists and the interpreters on today, oh God. And God, we know that your word is already blessed, and we thank you in advance for it right now in the name of Jesus. God, we pray that your word go out today and that it will do what it is supposed to. It will accomplish what you sent it out to do. So, God, I ask in the name of Jesus that your word rest upon the hearts and minds and the ears of the people that will hear your word today. And, God, maybe, just maybe someone that sits under your word today, God, they're not saved, but they will come running saying, what must I do to be saved in the name of Jesus? God, we want to thank you today. We want to bless you, oh God. We thank you, oh God, for the angel of this house, our pastor, oh God, the Reverend Dr. Lord T. McGriff. Father, we ask in the name of Jesus that you will continue to bless him, oh God. Let your blessings run over and overflow and take him, God, in the name of Jesus. Continue to bless his wife, oh God, Sister Monica, their children, the entire family. God, we want to thank you for the 21 years of pastoring people, Father, at this church, Father, Galilee, in the name of Jesus. Father, I even ask, God, that you would just take us higher in the service, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Bless every member, every family member, every friend, every visitor, oh God, here in this church. We give your name the glory, the honor, and the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on and bless him. Come on and put your hands together. And thank God for being God. Good morning to everyone around the country joining our worship services through streaming. Our announcements for this week. The Stir Up the Gift Ministry will be hosting an ice cream social today from 2 to 4 p.m. Grief Share 13-week series continues tomorrow at 6 p.m. Visit our church website for more details. Join us this Wednesday at 7 p.m. on Facebook Live for Galilee's topical summer series. This week's topic is humility. Invite others to join us for 30 minutes of an inspiring and encouraging word and how to apply it to your life. Virtual Vacation Bible School will be held Monday, tomorrow, July 19th, Wednesday, July 21st, and Friday, July 23rd. To join Galilee, text JOIN Galilee at 474747. That is the number that you will see throughout the service at the bottom of the screen. Hallelujah. At this time, we're going to take the service higher. We're going to be blessed by our guest soloist. Really, she's not a guest, but our guest soloist, Sister Gabrielle Jackson, amen. She is the daughter of Reverend Albert Jackson and Sister Shanetta Jackson. Come on, give God praise for this daughter.
Let's praise God, amen. Let's praise God and let's worship him on today, amen. Everybody clap your hands with me, amen, wherever you are. I'm chasing after you, no matter what I gotta do, 'cause I need you more and more. More and more, more and more, more and more, more. just to be closer to you. Clap your hands. I'm chasing after you. I'm chasing after you. I'm praising my way through just to be closer to you. Say, I'm chasing after, I'm chasing after you. More and more, 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 more and more. I'm chasing after you. To you, make it personal, amen. I'm chasing after you. I'm chasing after you. I'm praising my way through just to be closer to you. I'm chasing after you. Worship you in this place. We honor you. We bless your name. Yeah, yes, God. Somebody lift your hands. Somebody praise him. Yes, God. Somebody give him your best praise. I said your best praise. I said your best, your best. He's a perfect God. He's an awesome God. He's a gracious God. Hallelujah. God, we just bless your name. God, we just take the time to bless your name. We don't do it enough, but God, we bless your name. We thank you for all that you've done for us, God, because without you, we wouldn't be who we are. Amen. I would be nothing without you, God. That's why I want to make you smile, oh God. That's why I give you my best praise, God. That's why I give you my best worship, God. I give you everything I have. Because without you, I'd be nothing, God. Hey, yeah. Oh, oh, oh. Here's my worship. Sing it with me. I know you know it. Take joy in it. Wave your hand. Make it your dwelling place. I wanna put a smile on your face. I present my life to you. I present my heart to you.
We're gonna sing it again.
Here's my worship. Take joy. Make it your dwelling place. I wanna put a smile on your face. I present my life to you. say, I present my heart to you.
One more time.
Here's my worship. Take joy in it.
Make it your dwelling place.
Make it your dwelling place. I wanna put a smile on your face. I present my life to you.
Say I present my.
I present my heart to you. Here's my worship.
Make it personal.
Take joy in it. Wave your hands. Make it your dwelling place. I wanna put a smile on your face. I present my life to you. You
God, for putting a smile on our face. Oh, let me make, I want to make, I got to make a smile. We want to praise, we got to bless your name.
His name. This is the day the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. It's a blessing as we are able to connect, as we're able to worship, in spite of the challenges we face, in spite of the circumstances we find ourselves in. God is still worthy to be praised. You, like the psalmist and I, we all ought to be able to say, taste and see that the Lord is good. Listen, as you're joining and as we're connecting today, we know there's still power in prayer. Don't let anybody fool you. The prayers of the righteous availeth much. And so, as we gather and as we connect, won't you go into prayer with me and let us pray as we enter into this word that the Lord has for such a time as this. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for your power and your presence. We thank you that we are able to connect in spite of. Bless everyone watching. Give them what they stand in need of. Let us hear from you afresh and anew. Order our steps and direct our lives. And in the end, we'll give your name the glory, the honor, and the praise. Let us all say amen. Listen, we're so grateful. We're We were blessed by our psalmist, Sister Gabby Jackson. She did a wonderful job. We are so encouraged by her allowing God to use her, a young lady who is going to the next level, headed to Howard University, and so that's a blessing. We want to pray her strength in the Lord as she continues to put God first and watch God add all the other things. Listen, want to direct you today in the time that we have back to a text that we shared with you before. It's found in the Gospel of Matthew, the 14th chapter. In that 14th chapter of Matthew's Gospel, there's a word that we'd like to lift for such a time as this. Chapter 14 of Matthew, what is verse number 22? There in the 14th chapter of Matthew's Gospel, verse 22, we find these words, and straightway Jesus constrained his disciples to get into a ship and to go before him unto the other side. While he sent the multitude away, and when he had sent the multitudes away, he went up into a mountain apart to pray, and when the evening was come, he was there alone. But the ship was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary. And in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went unto them, walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, "It is a spirit." They cried out for fear. But straightway Jesus spake unto them, saying, "Be of good cheer, it is I, be not afraid." And Peter answered him and said, "Lord, if it be thou, bid me come unto thee on the water." And he said, "Come." And when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But when he saw the wind boisterous, he was afraid. And beginning to sink, he cried, saying, "Lord, save me." And immediately Jesus stretched forth his hand, caught him out, and said unto him, "O thou of little faith, wherefore didst thou doubt?" And when they were come into the ship, the wind ceased. Then they that were in the ship came and worshipped him, saying, "Of a truth, thou art the Son of God." I want to deal with this subject, challenging circumstances. That's where we want to go today, challenging circumstances. The scripture is very touching, it's very challenging, it's very empowering. When you read the scripture to really appreciate it, you must read a few verses before, because there you will find Jesus has performed one of his greatest miracles, feeding 5,000. We've talked about it when Jesus fed the 5,000 with just two fish, five loaves of bread. The people were in a wonder. They couldn't believe what they had witnessed. In fact, he fed those 5,000 and they took up scraps that fed another group of people, because there were 12 baskets full of scraps. I mean, it was miraculous. Just because a young lad had two fish and five loaves, put it in the master's hands, and he multiplied it. Surely the disciples had their chest out and their heads up because they could bask in such success. And yet, I want you to note how Jesus handles the situation. Verse 22, after everybody's been fed, Jesus does not linger and does not want the disciples to linger, but he says in verse 22, "Get into a ship and go to the other side." In other words, I don't want you to bask in this success. There's more to be done. There are more challenges ahead. There's more ministry to unfold. There are more people to touch. get into the ship and go to the other side. I'm dealing today with challenging circumstances because somebody needs to hear this particular message. You know firsthand about challenging circumstances at home, challenging circumstances with your health, challenging circumstances. Even with your wealth, there can be challenging circumstances. It just happens. And I thought we ought to look at it today, especially from the eyes of one of those disciples who had to witness everything that unfolded. His name, Peter. He was in the midst. He was there. In fact, as we keep reading, we'll find that they were sent to the other side. Many of those disciples had to say, why do we have to leave? I mean, we just and took part in a great miracle. Let's bask in this glory. Why should we go to the other side? Yet Jesus constrained his disciples. He urged them, go to the other side. In other words, there had to be some pushback. Some didn't want to go. Some wanted to stay. But Jesus constrained them. He impressed it upon them. He urged them, go to the other side. For Jesus knew what would await them. And I want to commend the disciples because they adhered to the master's command. They followed instructions. They got into the ship and began to row onto the other side. They began working, making their way to where Jesus wanted them to go. Now, be clear, as they are roaring, this is not anything new for them. They probably made this journey many a time. I mean, it's a short trip to the other side, the northern tip of the sea. It's not far. They've done it before, and so they begin, and yet from the time of their departure, before they get to their destiny, something happens, and that's where I want to draw you in today. It's in verse 24, but the ship was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary. I like the way the Message Bible says it. Meanwhile, the boat was far out to sea when the wind came up against them and they were battered by the waves. It's about 4 o'clock in the morning, and there they are, dark. There they are, uncertain, unsure, in the midst of a storm. Somebody had to be saying, why didn't we stay? I didn't sign up for this. Challenging. You get my direction. Why didn't we just stay on dry ground? Why are we here? Why deal with this? I didn't sign up for this. You know, when you follow God's directions, you will hit some challenges. That's what I want you to grab today. Somebody needs to hear that just because you're doing it God's way doesn't mean you're not going to have some friction, some obstacles. Just because the Lord is directing you doesn't mean it's going to be smooth sailing. Anybody know what I'm talking about? I started off talking about challenges. It's inevitable. It happens. It happens. It can happen. It can happen with your health. It can happen with your wealth. It can happen in your relationships. It can happen. Challenges at home. It can happen at the job. Just because you're doing it the Lord's way doesn't mean it's going to be smooth sailing. Somebody can say, I'm a witness. I know firsthand. Been trying to do it God's way, but there's always something. There's always a setback. There's always a wall I run into. There's always something I have to deal with. You can identify with this message. You can identify with what we're trying to express today, challenging circumstances. Just because you follow Jesus doesn't mean you will avoid storms. The disciples can say we are witnesses. This particular disciple, I want to lift Peter. He can declare it. He's positioned there. You know Peter, bold, boisterous, outspoken. Peter's in the midst of the storm. Peter is there on the ship. Peter is challenged on the ship in the midst of the storm. Fourth watch. All of a sudden, verse 26 says, and when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, Jesus walks out. They don't know who he is. They say, it is a spirit. And they cried out for fear, afraid. They literally are overcome with fear, immobilized. They don't know who's coming at them. They are afraid. It's the fourth watch, 4 a.m. in the morning, ship being tossed to and fro, waves, winds, storm, thunder, roaring. And all of a sudden, they see something and someone coming towards them, afraid. But hear me, in the midst of facing your challenges, in the midst of your uncertainty, always look for Jesus. It's in this text. Verse 27, but straightway Jesus spake unto them. Listen to his words. Be of good cheer. It is I. Be not afraid. Now, that's got to be mind-blowing in the midst of a storm, in the midst of being tossed to and fro at sea, in the midst of uncertainty, that you hear these words, be of good cheer. It is I, be not afraid. But somebody can attest to the fact that Jesus does his best work when you least expect it. There in the storm, the fourth watch, 4 a.m. in the morning, being tossed to and fro, Jesus says, be of good cheer. It is I, be not afraid. And that's where I want us to drop anchor, because there's a voice that comes behind this command. And that voice is the voice of Peter, who answered him. And Peter says, Lord, if it be thou, bid me come unto thee on the water. There it is, verse 28. The Message Bible says it this way. Peter, suddenly bold, said, Master, if it's really you, call me to come to you on the water. I see him. He's saying, if it's you, I want to be where you are. If it's you, I know you can do extraordinary things. If it's you, allow me to do what you're doing. Now, there were 12 disciples on the ship, but one spoke out. And I want you to see the one that spoke out. Hearing these words come back from Jesus. And he said, come. It's in verse 29. And Peter got out of the ship. Jumping out of the boat, Peter walked on the water to Jesus. If the story had stopped right there, that would have been enough. Not only did Jesus defy gravity, but now he's allowed Peter to step out of comfort, safety, security, and now he defies gravity and he's walking on water. I want you to envision what's unfolding. The 11 are watching in amazement. Peter is moving towards the master. He's walking. Can you see him? Can you envision it? He's walking towards the master. It is life-defying. It is extraordinary. It is a miracle in the making. Peter is walking towards Jesus. When all of a sudden, verse 30 comes, and Peter starts focusing on his challenges. The storm is there. He saw the wind boisterous. He was afraid. It's there in verse 30. He done the miraculous. He stepped out of the comfort zone. He defied gravity. He's walking on water. When all of a sudden, he lost his nerve. He took his eyes off Jesus. Let me help you today. Because there are challenges all around us. Challenges with a COVID-19. Challenges with an economy. challenges with political unrest, challenges with foolishness that's all over the airwaves, challenges trying to work day to day, trying to be consistent, trying to stay focused. Challenges are all around us, but if you keep your eyes on Jesus, he won't allow you to sink. I see it in this text. He took his eyes off Jesus and he began to sink. And when he began to sink, fully clothed, can you envision it? He's sinking, going down. It looks like it's over. It appears as though he's through. He's defied gravity. When it was going well, it was going well, but now he's sinking. He took his eyes off Jesus. I want to share with you this illustration. I was just reading it. You know, there's a NBA championship going on, and in basketball, that NBA championship, there's a need to what commentators would call a rebound. You got to get a rebound. Even when you take a shot, you need a rebound, because sometimes you'll miss. In basketball, one of the most important skills for players to have is the ability to rebound. Rebounds occur because a shot somewhere has been missed. There's no need for a rebound unless something has been missed. If a shot was missed, that means a shot was attempted, but somehow something went wrong in the attempt that caused the shot to be missed, and therefore we have the need for a rebound. Stick with me. One reason a shot can be missed is that a player was off in their perspective. They were looking at the goal, but what they saw and what they did didn't match. They were unable to sink the basket. They may have shot too short, too long, too hard, or too soft. There was not a correlation from the eye to the action. You get what I'm saying? Another reason that shots are missed in basketball is because the opposing team is in a player's face. It's the job of the opposing team to wave their hands in the shooter's face and obstruct their view. They are supposed to provide a distraction. Sometimes shots are missed because a player is fouled. A foul means that a player has been illegitimately handled, produced an inability for them to make the shot. Any coach will want their player to follow up on their shot, to go for the rebound or get the missed shot. Here in the text, there's a missed shot. Peter, he started off well. He has the right eye contact. He's moving. He's stepping on water, defying gravity. But along the way, as he's putting left foot in front of right, he gets obstructed view. The enemy has got into his perspective, and he now takes his eyes off the prize. He stops looking at Jesus and starts looking at the obstacle, the storm, the wind, the struggle, the trouble. Anybody know what I'm talking about? In your life, in my life, in our lives, we can lose our perspective. We can get our eyes off the prize. We can miss what the Lord wants to do in us and through us and for us, because we start looking at what's wrong instead of gazing on God and thanking him for what's right. Peter starts sinking, but then he cried out, like you and I have to cry out when we miss some shots in life. We got to cry out. We got to call on him. We got to be able to say, Lord, I need you. I can't make it without you. He said, Lord, save me. Anybody watching today able to cry out in spite of missed shots, missed opportunities, wrong moves, Lord, save me? It's all right to cry to him. It's all right to call on him. It's all right to tell him you need him. Lord, save me. Anybody watching today, anybody connected right now, anybody willing to be transparent enough to say, Lord, save me. I can't do it. I can't make it. It's not working. I need help. Lord, save me. Peter said, Lord, save me. And the text says, by verse 31, and immediately, Jesus stretched forth his hand, caught him. Anybody watching today glad to be able to report, he caught me. On my way down, he caught me. When I was messed up, mixed up, and tore up from the floor up, he caught me. Aren't you glad he caught you? Aren't you glad he's got you in his hands? Aren't you glad his grip won't let you sink? Aren't you glad he didn't let you go? Praise his name. They got back into the ship. Now, some people would get mad at Peter saying, you took your eyes off the prize, but you ought to affirm him, because at least he got out the boat. At least he was willing to trust God. At least he was willing to say, Lord, if you say it, I trust it and I'll do it. That ought to be our mantra today. Lord, I'll follow you. Lord, I trust you. Even when I'm dealing with in my life challenging circumstances, I'm going to hold to your unchanging hand. That's the message today, challenging circumstances. But keep your eyes on Jesus. Not on the storm, not on the trouble, not on the setback, not on the issues at hand, but keep your eyes on Jesus. Today, as you're watching and as you're connecting, I want to encourage you. There are numbers coming up on the screen. I want to encourage you, reach out. The Lord wants to work in your life. He wants to fix it for you. Will you let him in? Connect. He wants to work it in you, through you, and for you. But you have to be willing to say, Lord, save me. So many who are watching right now can say, I'm so glad I told him, Lord, save me. It's the invitation. Connect. Make a move. Shift. Change. Lord, save me. Let's have a word of prayer. Lord, you know who's standing in need today. You know their circumstance and situation. Move on their lives. Touch them right where they are. Save in a miraculous way. Let them know you are still a way maker, a burden bearer, a heart fixer, and a mind regulator. In the name of Jesus, move, touch, affirm, encourage, and we shall be careful to give you the glory, honor, and praise. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for joining us today. Challenging circumstances, but keep your eyes on Jesus. Be blessed. Be encouraged. God is not through with you yet. And now unto him who's still able to keep all of us from falling, to him be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, now and forever. Amen.
Okay, baby, we're here. Now, I know this is a new school and all, but remember, God has not given us a spirit of fear, right?
Yes, Dad, I know. But I just don't know anybody here, and I want to make a difference for Christ. I do, but I just don't know if I can.
Oh, baby, just remember, in Jesus, you got this.
Okay, Dad, if you say so.
In the Bible, Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength.
Then if God said it, I have to believe it.
That means in Jesus, we got this, we got this, we got this.
So what happens if a bully comes to confront me?
Man, in Jesus, you got this.
Okay, so what if it seems like I just don't fit in?
Man, I told you, in Jesus, we got this.
Here we go, y'all.
Every step I take,
let's go, let's
every
go.
Move I make,
come on.
Whether asleep or awake, there is no mistake.
Uh-huh.
My God is in the midst, fear just can't exist.
That's right.
With Jesus I can't miss, with Jesus
let's
see
go.
I live. Every step I take, every move I make,
yeah.
Whether asleep or awake,
let's go, let's
there
go.
Is no mistake.
Yeah.
My God is in the midst,
uh-huh.
Fear just can't exist.
Ever been in a situation you said you just can't win? The enemy harassing me, I need me a super friend. Then he realized Jesus was there all along. Now you got the power to do all these, 'cause he makes you strong.
I'll never walk alone.
Take a look in your Bible. You see who the Son sets free is free indeed. But take heed, the enemy will still try to foul you out when you shoot your three. The game is on the line, you're out of time. You take the shot and you think you missed, but it's your time to shine from the line. Jesus just in time
with the assist.
With Jesus, there's absolutely nothing you cannot do. You cannot do. 'Cause every hour your superpower is the greater one inside of you. Now rise up and take this amazing message all around the world. You agree, 'cause you know, after all, with great power comes great responsibility.
Every step I take,
let's go, let's
every
go.
Move I make,
come on.
Whether asleep or awake, there is no mistake.
Uh-huh.
My God is in the midst, fear just can't exist.
That's right.
With Jesus I can't miss, with Jesus
let's go.
Every step I take, every move I make,
yeah.
Whether asleep or awake,
let's go, let's
there
go.
Is no mistake.
Yeah.
My God is in the midst,
uh-huh.
Fear just can't exist.
Yeah.
With Jesus I can't miss, with Jesus we got this.
Okay, so how was your day?
You were right, Dad. It was great. 'Cause with Jesus, we both got this.
Greetings, worshipers, and welcome to Galilee Baptist Church. We are so glad you have joined us for virtual worship. Here are the announcements and events for this month and week.
Join us this Wednesday at 7 p.m. on Facebook Live for Galilee's topical summer series. This week's topic is humility. Invite others to join us for 30 minutes of an inspiring and encouraging word and how to apply it to your life. Join us for our 2021 Virtual Vacation Bible School. This year's theme is, I've Got This with Jesus. Sessions will be held via Zoom. The dates are Monday, July 19th, Wednesday, July 21st, and Friday, July 23rd at 7 p.m. The meeting ID is 810-0969-3433, and the passcode is 082603. You don't want to miss this. Join the Stir Up the Gift Youth Ministry as they host an ice cream social today, Sunday, July 18th from 2 to 4 p.m. at our Shadyside location. Gospel aerobics is held every Monday from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. See the website for login information.
Please continue to join us Monday through Friday at 12 p.m. for Joy at Noon for an encouraging word. Go to our website for information on how to call in and listen. Also, our virtual worship service is held each Sunday at 9 a.m. on our website, GalileeNow.tv, and on Facebook Live. If you missed us at 9 o'clock, don't worry. Catch us at 10:30 a.m. for a rebroadcast via our YouTube page, username Galilee Media. Bible study is held each Wednesday at 7 p.m. on Facebook Live. You don't have Facebook? Don't worry. Go to our website, scroll to the bottom of the page, and click on the Facebook icon. No sign-in required. Bible study will be posted on the main page of our website at the conclusion of services. And now, back to our service here at Galilee Baptist Church, where our senior pastor is the Reverend Dr. Lloyd T. McGriff. We are a church determined to grow for Christ through worship, evangelism, and discipleship. The journey continues as we are building by faith, expanding for the future.